In this video, we will introduce the basics about one basic process in communications, the modulations. We have two types of bands, the baseband that contains the DC or the zero hertz band, and the bandpass, which does not contain this band. To go from baseband to bandpass, you need to modulate. So this means to go from this band, the baseband, to this band. Consequently, the way back to be done in the receiver, going from bandpass to baseband, should be done via the modulator. There are a lot of different modulations, both analog and digital. In this course, we will see some of them. Reasons to modulate. The first one and most important is to go to higher frequencies, adapting better the signal to the channel. The second one is that modulating allows us to transmit multiple signals at the same time, and we call this process frequency multiplexing. And also, we can increase the signal bandwidth to raise the immunity against noise, but this is only done by some types of modulations, not by every one of them. In the practical part of this course, we will get into more details about modulations, doing a lot of examples. But now you only need to know that a modulation is also a mathematical operation, which has, of course, a physical implementation, with some electronics, with some black boxes, and there are many different types of modulations. There is no one better than the others. It only depends on the circumstance, on the circumstances, on the applications. So all of them have pros and cons. We will work with digital modulations, but we will also see some good examples on analog modulations. Modulating is introducing the information signal into the signal that we will transmit. This signal to be transmitted will be in a different frequency. So here we can see this signal will be the information signal, and this signal will be the one to be transmitted. You can see in this example the double sideband modulation, which is a case of amplitude modulation, that the information signal is in the amplitude of the transmitted signal, and the frequency of the transmitted signal, FC, it's fixed, it's the carrier frequency. Here, if you look at the picture in the left, you can see that the signal changes very rapidly. This frequency is the carrier frequency. But if you only look at the slow changes in the amplitude of the signal, you can reconstruct the information signal. This is depicted here. So, this is a good example of modulation, amplitude modulation. If we look at the spectrum of the signal, we can see that this is the information signal, and when we modulate it, what we do is to go from the baseband, remember, containing the zero hertz band, to a band that does not contain this DC component. We have modulated the signal. We call this modulation double sideband because you will have two bands, the upper one and the lower one. Also look that the bandwidth of the modulated signal now it's twice the bandwidth of the information signal. Another example, a digital modulation. Now the information will not be in the amplitude, it will be in the frequency. So if we transmit one, you will have a signal, a sinusoidal signal with some frequency, for example F1. If you transmit a zero, you will have the signal in green with another frequency. You can see that this frequency is not the same as here. Again, if you transmit one, you will have to do it at F1 signal. That's it. Thank you for your attention.